Okay, before I head down in that direction, I actually should probably check out these points of interest. I was just looking at my world map and going, alright, where am I going exactly? Well, apparently not up the side of this hill. Damn it, Roach! I can improve how much stamina you have, I can make sure you're not as afraid of everything, but you can't scale mountains. I need a magic horse. One with, like, no legs, just, like, hover devices or something.
Come on, Roach.
Alright, what is at this point in rest? Is it gonna be a place of power? Or is it gonna be monsters? Guarded treasure. Guarded treasure. Oh, hello! Ow! That was the wrong ability! But that's fine, because I killed the thing immediately. So, what does it give me? A short letter and some crafting ingredients. Okay. What is super important on the short letter? My dearest Master Sigvard, I have received your letter. I thus now know that you have a great many doubts regarding the contract I have offered you, and that you clearly suffer from gross misconceptions regarding the nature of a mercenary's trade, something which, given that this is a trade you yourself profess to practice, constitutes a highly puzzling paradox. So let me inform you that a mercenary is not paid for asking questions or listing reservations, but for performing a concrete task. This task was described in simple, unambiguous words. You are to capture a siren, alive, and bring her to me. If you will not perform this task, you are of no interest to me. As to why I need this siren or what I intend to do with her, that should not be of any interest to you. If these conditions do not suit you, I am sure I will find another man who will not refuse my coin. Count de Botton. You want to capture a siren alive, huh? I have some questions about that too. I mean, yeah. That just sounds like a good way to get yourself killed or hurt. Can I examine this? This red blood, which usually indicates that I can examine it? Obviously the answer is no, because I tried. Although I didn't really pause over it. There have been a couple of times where that happens, where I'm like walking around something and I have to like stop before it lets me investigate. Yeah, okay. The way I feel about these things sometimes is if it doesn't immediately let me try examining something, it probably doesn't want me to do it. Oh boy. No, I want to go up! I wish to ascend this mountain! Okay, alright, so which direction am I heading to? We are going down this way. So can I get Roach up here? Roach! Alright, this is probably a really bad idea. Yeah, okay. But it will be a lot faster than sliding down it. Oh boy. If I make even the slightest mistake in my navigation of this mountain, Roach is gonna like slide down and die. What is going on over there? Hold up! Roach isn't letting me move anymore, so we're gonna- oh boy. Stop to examine things. Okay. I see a fire in the distance. Why? It looks kind of like a statue. Is that a point of interest? It's not listed as a point of interest. Very interesting. Well, I kind of want to check it out. I mean, I could continue going along this mountain, but I want to check it out. All right, we're going to save real quick before I end up dying. We have things to do. Oh boy, okay. Fucking Geralt is extreme, man. And then all of a sudden, goats. The goats praise the statue fire god. Seriously, what the hell is this? There are people here. Okay, it's a fucking holy site! The Grimjar's monument? What's going on here?
What happened?
What happened, dammit? Is it I fell and cracked me damn leg in two?
Stop whining, Peter. I'm ashamed to hear it. Pull yourself together, man. Worst case, Henrik will whittle you a wooden leg. Old Olla's got one, and you don't hear him complaining.
Old Olla's also got lice, stinks and leaks out of both ends. Yet he don't complain about that either. You two gonna help or no?
You'll do fine without me. That'd be mean.
How'd you fall?
We set out to light a fire there. Atop of the statue's shoulders. For our own glory and that of our ancestors.
Looks like you succeeded.
Aye, but the fire won't big so quick. Petter jumped back. Lost his balance.
Got lucky anyway. Could have broken his neck falling from that height. This statue, what is it?
An altar to the god of warriors. Any man who dares climb it and light the fire gains the favor of the gods. Fame and...
And an excellent chance of snapping his leg off at the arse. Are you going to help me or are you going to continue preaching?
Obviously the gods don't favor you that much if you broke your leg pretty immediately.
This celandine should help you. Won't mend your leg, but it will make it hurt less.
Thanks. Our undying gratitude, that gets you.
The gratitude of a dying man in my case. Enjoy it while it lasts.
Shut it and show me that leg. Thanks again. God's guide you.
You're welcome. No, it's a good thing you guys lit this thing on fire. Or lit the fire next to it, because I probably wouldn't have tried helping you. Well, I mean, if I had come around here eventually, yes, I would help them, but I wouldn't have caught my attention if it was just a rock. I'd have been like, oh, that's a big rock formation thing. I'm not interested. No, the fire is what got me. All right, where am I heading to? I always have to kind of check. All right. I had the general area nailed down. You can't see the statue thing on the map. It's really weird. Usually something significant like that would be noticeable, but no, not really. All right, we're continuing onwards. I gotta get my Griffin school gear because we've been using this one or this set for a very, very long time. It's about time that I swap over. At least so my Griffin school stuff looks better. I don't know what's going on over there. Wolves, we'll say. Hello. Siege tower?
Come on, Roach.
Is there anything of importance around said siege tower? We have the manuscript for superior Ogryn oil. I mean, I don't have the enhanced ingredient thing for it, but whatever.
Give me up.
You take what you can get, and eventually find an herbalist or an alchemist or whoever, and actually get legitimate diagrams. I need to look at a map on Google. So I can find someone in Skellige, because I'm sure that someone in Skellige can sell me diagrams for potions.
That's
and oils, right? There are a few people who could do that in Novigrad, or rather, the Velen region, so assuming the same thing around here. Hello. Did someone just leave a chest out? Oh. It had a candle in it, so yeah, I guess that would explain it. Didn't need to bring the candle, just fuck that chest, it's too heavy.
Faster.
You know, I've seen a very surprising lack of, bandits and stuff along this road. Right? Like, when we were in Velen, we were exploring this big region. Oh, whoops, I missed something. But we were exploring this big region where we just kept on running into bandits every other, minute or something. And that was ridiculous. Hello, bear. It's two bears! Oh no! It looked like one! It looked like one bear! Ah! Oh boy. Oh boy.
Come on.
Oh, it's not dead! I figured, level 12, I can handle that pretty easily. Nah, apparently not. Whew. Someone's been getting on my case a couple of times. Not too badly, but they've been like, you're disappointing me because you're setting people on fire and then hitting them, which is canceling the fire. And you're not wrong. That is definitely something I've been noticing the entire time, but I've never really been cared much to do it. Usually for me, what I use Igni for is to stun them for a second long enough for me to hit them. The fire damage itself is kind of inconsequential, but I guess I should take a little bit more of an advantage of it, especially with tougher human enemies. But things have been working the way they have been, so we'll see what ends up happening. Ugh, damn it. I'm trying to find my way into this place. And I figure climbing a wall would be a good start. Oh, there's a big door in the front. Okay. I was on that side and didn't see it, so good job on me. How the hell did I miss that? I guess just angling. Yeah, I can see it. I just very quickly ran past this small-ass opening. Alright, Harpies! Bring it! Harpies should be a lot easier to deal with than all those sirens been fighting ass. Get close enough for me to smack you dead! Whoops, that was an accident. You know, one of these days someone's gonna make it so you can consistently attack things that have been knocked down to the ground. That'll be nice. Maybe it'll be, CD Projekt themselves.
Harpy's got their nest here.
There you go. Say goodbye to your nest. And will they assault me for it? There's quite a few of them sitting off in the distance, kind of not really caring. Well, there you go. You guys lost your nest because you didn't want to try and defend it. Not my fault. Right, we're gonna get out of here. Shoo! Get out of here, goats! Flee! There's gotta be... Maybe there's another monster's nest up there, because that seems like an entirely different group of harpies. But you know what? Fuck them. I don't care. I don't fucking... Leave them be. Although, it'd be bad to leave monsters just chilling out around the place, right? I'm a witcher. It's my job to kill these things.
What now, you piece of filth?
They're just yelling at everything. Ow. No! Stop me dodging! Gotta kill you guys! Dude, holy shit! That was, really impressive for Geralt to do. He just spun around and instant shot him. Okay, I just pressed X to finish off. Thank you. Okay. They didn't really, there wasn't a monster's nest. So, no, I guess they were just supposed to be here defending the front entrance to the base. Poor show. Poor show on their part. They did a very bad job of it. And now everything's ruined. If there were sentient harpies, they'd be very disappointed in everything. What the fuck? Another harpy? Hold on. We're killing this one. I don't trust survivors. Survivors can lay eggs. Okay? I can't aim straight up. Fuck. I can't look straight up! Come on! You're a harpy! I'm a witcher, you wanna attack me? I'm jumping! Here we go! Got it! I tried to shoot it, but it took too long to reload. There. Now, obviously, harpies can't actually legitimately repopulate the world in The Witcher 3. But it's all about role-playing. Can't allow the monsters to survive. It'd just be a bad idea. Alright. I guess I must have accidentally hit the right thumbstick because it selected the other sword. No, we're good. We're going to the one closest, which is at the end of this island. Or... isle? God. The end of this particular chunk of land, which also happens to be in the middle of the ocean. Ooh, hold on. What's going on out here? A lot of death and... woo, sirens. Oh, that is, maybe a little bit too many. How many fucking walls are there? Holy shit!
And then there's a cave down here. Okay, I know I complained about not really seeing too many things in a row, but I think we're good now. You can chill out, game. Ooh, is that a lighthouse? Is that the lighthouse I got a contract for? I got a lighthouse contract, or a contract for a monster that's haunting a lighthouse. And I remember when we first came to Skellige and we helped out that dude with the Black Pearl mission, we encountered a lighthouse. This isn't that one, but I was kind of interested. Actually, is this even a lighthouse? I'd assume it is. Okay. Well, I guess we're gonna have to get off our horse and just try fighting everything. Vilrum Lighthouse. Well, there you go. Confirmed. It's a lighthouse. Damn it! That's cute. Ow. I was gonna say it's cute. One of them is, staying in her normal humanish form, and the other one is not. Where are you going? Ow. My Quen knocked it to the ground. That's great. There. So what's hiding in the tower? A guarded treasure? Maybe a Witcher school here? Diary of a Fire Swallower. Ooh. That's probably nothing incredibly amazing, but I'll read it eventually. Maybe. Fuck it. All right. Let's see if there's anything there. I have three of it. Wow. I was at Loch Mooin. That's right. The summit of summits itself. Was it the one where shit went down? No. Yes. Yes. This guy was at Loch Mooin when shit went down. Radovid had even brought the Knightly Order of the Flaming Rose, those arrogant pricks ready to bash anyone who doesn't think the same as them. Though the coin was coming in amply, we didn't wait around to see how things would develop, just loaded our stuff onto wagon and left our trot. As we mounted the pass, we looked back to see pillars of smoke, black as pitch, rising above Loch Mooin. Yeah, the shit that went down, I had to, look back through my footage of The Witcher 2 to be like, okay, what happened to Loch Mooin again? I mean, obviously I remembered shit went down, but I wanted to see exactly what, like, the cutscenes and things were. Bad times were had. And I remember, exactly what happened with Philip. I was like, how'd she lose Rye Balls? Oh yeah, we found her that way. She was being tortured. Yeah, Witcher 2 decided to get real dark. You know, we haven't really had that many moments like that in The Witcher 3. Like, just moments of outright terror and, like, everyone's getting tortured and everything like that. Obviously, we've had a few dark moments. You know, we had that vampire who burned people by fucking, like, shoving formaldehyde down their throats. We had people being legitimately, literally burned at the stakes. That was all interesting. Alright, hold on. We gotta look at the Witcher sign.
Might wanna look around some.
That way, my thing updates. Alright. Don't know what kind of monsters are gonna be in here, but they look like they're kind of fast, so I'm assuming Neckers. And you know what? I have the oil vlot. Let me just get down to it. Damn it, okay. We're entering the dark area. I should have just equipped this immediately. Cat. Oh, this is a sizable cave. Actually, it's drowners. Drowners. I mean, good because I have a more effective oil for them, but damn it. Drowners. They're always a bother. They kick my ass. Because they just have really longish range attacks when shit starts going down. Am I not gonna run into the drowners? Huh. Am I gonna run into anything? like, say, a vampire. I'm worried. Griffin Silver Sword, superior. Okay. So far, I'm not being brutally murdered. So that's a big plus. Let me look at what we just got. Okay. Silver Sword. Griffin Superior Sword. It is level 26. Ouch. it's a little bit furry. I mean, I know it's only like 5 levels. But it's not now. And that means it's far. But 80 plus damage versus what I've got now. I can't effectively compare some of the other stats, but it's gonna be better gear than what I've got on now, and the Witcher gear is all probably the best gear in the game. Although I still want to try out that one sword that has the frost damage. I really want to, like, slap on a bunch of frost runes onto it. The only problem is I need the science for the greater ruins, runes. I like how the game saved. Yeah, I agree. I should save too before I fight this bear. Greetings, bear! Yes, you've seen me. Now fight me. I'm right here. Big door, big entrance. Yes. I'm gonna light you on fire. How's that gonna make you feel? Hurts pretty badly, doesn't it? Makes you want to back up into me. No, no, not at all. Okay. Alright. Oh, it was a white bear. I figured it did kind of look like the colors were a bit off. That looks like poison gas. We're gonna push that out of the way real quick. Or it could just be fog. Okay, it's just fog. What is further down here? Oh, light! So, the reason how come we saw drowners was not because the drowners were inside the cave with a flooded segment. It was because they were out on the beach. Got you. You know what? That makes a lot of sense. It makes a lot more sense than what I was thinking. I just thought there was going to be an underwater cave segment, and there were a bunch of drowners there. Okay. Well, we need to get out of this cave. There is another cave somewhere nearby. Is this the exit? It's hard to tell sometimes. I think this is the exit. Yeah, there we go. My eyes. We're gonna keep Cat on because there's another cave a little bit far down here where all those sirens were. And I figure if I'm gonna go in there, I might as well save. I shouldn't actually not think about it. I'm more or less burning everyone's eyes while heading to this fucking thing. I don't even know I'm going the right area. Yep, nope, we found it. Alright. Greetings, sirens! I've got shit to do. I don't even know if this is a cave. No, it's not. Wow. Alright, I'm a fuck. My eyes burn at the sight of boobs and flying death. No. Ow. Alright, I deserve that. I wanted to try, hitting her. So I could do a slap down, an instant kill on her. But angles are bad. I find that it's probably the angles that are really screwing us the most in terms of not being able to get our instant kills. Because whenever they're like on an edge or something, that's when suddenly, oh no, I can't instant kill them. There we go.
There's one last siren around here.
Come! Your sisters are dead, and I'm sure you wish to join them. I don't think sirens have any kind of belief in anything, but yeah, no, come on over. Alright, that worked. Kind of. Although it went underwater, and it's a bad place for me. Alright, we're gonna back it up a little bit so that way my camera doesn't get shoved into the ground. Bam! Alright. Dude! If I had been able to do the instant kill there, that would have been a really... There we go. Awesome kill! It just falls to my feet and I get a murder? Dude, that's some cinematic shit.
All right. Nothing good. That's fine. I'm used to disappointment. I'm gonna meditate. Or we could burn it off for another hour. Okay. I know I have like hundreds of alcohol at this point, but I don't wanna. I wanna waste it on nothing. All right. One of these was the more important siren. Just wanted to make sure to grab whatever it had on it, because you never know. The superior potions might need other things, and can't you get like mastercrafted potions too? Maybe not. But that'd be awesome to have mastercrafted gear. Uh-oh. Sorry, Roach. You have a bolt in your butt. You have another bolt in your butt. Those were completely accidental. Okay. So where am I heading to now that I've explored all that? I was hoping to explore these little areas, but there's no boat, so I guess I could just head over to the other Griffin School gear from here. Yeah, we're gonna do a long trek. Yeah, no, we're gonna go a long trek around across the coastal line, because why not?